Hey, Kenan, Tom, campers, Chuck here. Hope everybody's start of their spring is doing awesome. Just want to share with you guys a little montage of me feeding Mazuri tortoise chow to the critters in my collection that eat it. Up first is some baby spiny-tailed iguanas, Honduran spiny-tailed iguanas. They love it. Mixed in with that Mazuri is also some rapache grub pie so that they can get their protein. That's a good gel product to supplement insects. It's easy to make and very easy to feed, and a bunch of my lizards love grub pie. So these guys are doing awesome. I have eight left of the 30 some odd that hatched in October of last year. This little lady right here is Lana, our Russian tortoise rescue that a good friend asked me to take about a year and a half ago. Knew somebody they didn't think was taking care of her right. She is doing awesome. She loves her Missouri as well, and can't wait to get her outdoors here once the nighttime temps here in Virginia start warming up a little bit. Everybody you see, other than the babies, will be going outside this summer. And of course, here is Lucky. Lucky is from Tiamat's first clutch of babies. She loves Missouri. The reason she's named Lucky is when that batch of eggs were laid and everybody was hatching, I didn't think she was going to hatch out of her egg. She was looked like she may have been stillborn, I guess. I don't know if that's the right terminology for a reptile and an egg. But my wife said, nope, it's moving. So we let her alone that night. And sure enough, she hatched out the next morning, just missing a chunk of her tail. But that's why she's lucky. And of course, here is Bosk on the right-hand side and Tiamat there on the left. And that's Lucky's parents. They're doing awesome. I know they're looking forward to getting out in their suncatcher aviary that I've converted to iguana-ary, I guess if that's a word. Bosk and Tiamat are awesome medium-sized iguanas that do okay indoors, a little more manageable indoors than, say, a big green iguana or cyclura. But I do like to keep them outside during the summer because obviously that natural sunlight benefits them immensely. They're doing awesome, and of course, Bosk is my pride and joy. He is just a really cool, chill, laid-back iguana. I don't handle them per se. I don't pick them up and carry them around with me. But he's never tried to bite me. Lets me pet him. Lets me pet the back of his head under his dewlap. Very, very tolerant of my presence and well acclimated to people being around. And when I get them outside, I can't wait to share some videos with you guys of being outside with them. And of course, here is Indy. Indy is my leopard tortoise that I've had since 2011. She's got a little bit of pyramiding. We've talked about that before. Probably some husbandry mistakes on my part when she was new, but she is doing excellent, and she loves her Missouri. So had to she wanted to come over. I think she was looking at the LED light on the phone as I'm filming this. That's why it's a little shaky too. I'm not using any of my cool cameras. I just decided to knock this thing out on my cell phone so I could get an April video submitted before the deadline so that I didn't waste a month. But Indy is doing great, and she is a cool tortoise. I love the leopard tortoises. Up next here are two of my newest animals. I haven't, had any animals, bought any animals in years, but these are kind of my dream species. I've always liked the hingeback tortoises. These are Horne's hingeback tortoises, Canixes homiana. They are from Africa. As far as their diet, it is quite similar to North American box turtles. They are omnivorous, so they like protein as well as vegetation and fruit. And they love tortoise chow, as you can see. So this one right here, this is the female. She's slightly larger than the male, and you'll see him. He'll finally realize that there's some food in the enclosure here momentarily. I do want to get them outside this summer, but they definitely need really warm temps, so I got to make sure whatever hide box I have for them is well heated for cool nights. I can't have them getting sick because it gets cool. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this. Just a little feeding montage. I think Missouri is a great product as a treat, as a supplement to greens and fresh produce and whatever protein they may need. But until next time, until next month when I can upload something, everybody take care.